You know, before the race begins, anything is possible. Anything. On the one hand, you have the true icons of the sport, certain drivers, certain teams who set the pace, who you expect to do well. On the other hand, you have the underdogs. And we are always there, always pushing for another place, another point, looking for the smallest opportunity, the tiniest mistake we can punish. And in that moment, just before lights out, it's like the world holds its breath, you know? Everybody just waits. The air is heavy, you know? And I knew whatever happened. Corner sport had made its mark on the history of the sport. And I was at peace with that.
So you weren't nervous?
Are you kidding?
So we know how it stands right now, but just how different might it be when the checkered flag waves here in Abu Dhabi? And it's lights out, and away we go!
Okay, Aidan, let's see if we can start moving through the field. It's time to push. Come on, you got this. Copy that. Our gap behind is 3.3 seconds. Our head is 2.3 seconds.
The main straight we go. Here goes Jackson again, moving up the field. What a great race for him.
Yeah, it really is so far, Prof. I mean, it's a circuit he really enjoys. Remember the race in 2021 that he put together there? It was fantastic stuff back then.
Who could forget it? Connor Sport need a performance just like that today. Mayer's doing okay. Jackson really delivering.
Great stuff, Aidan. Come on, I think we can get one more place here. Push, push. Something's not right. Assessing. Stand by. I'm losing speed.
Heading down the back straight now. He's in a great spot, but hang on, he's slowing. Something is very, very wrong.
Yeah, I think he's got a problem here, Crofty. I wonder what it is. Could it be engine related?
Look, they're throwing their hands in the air on the pit wall, and he's out.
And yeah, that's the engine gone.
2023 is over for Aidan Jackson. It's a dramatic exit, and it wasn't what he was hoping for.
Something happened up there.
Yeah, engine failure, I'm afraid. Aidan is out of this race. Repeat, Aidan's out of the race. Did you get that?
Aidan's out. I heard.
What?
Let me speak to them.
Why?
Just give me the headset.
Sure about this?
I'm sure about everything.
That's what concerns me.
Kelly.
Devin?
Yeah, we've had a chat. We think it's best if you don't push the car too hard.
What? Why?
Look, you're way back, Cal, okay? We don't want to blow your engine too, so just cruise it in and finish the race.
It's got to be realistic here. Copy.
Sorry, is this a team order?
No, Casper agrees. You're just not going to make up that much ground. It can't be done. Just cruise it in, Cal. Trust me, you watch her go.
Work, mate, that brings you up a place. Okay, that's us with 5 laps of fuel remaining. 5 laps of fuel left. Got enough fuel for 3 more laps. Okay, you've just started the final lap of the race. Final lap.
time. That is some race from Callie Mayer.
What an incredible performance by her today. Connor Sport sure will be very delighted with that one.
And if you believe the rumours, Ant, this is a team whose future has been in doubt. Surely, though, they've done enough to return next season. I think they've been wonderful to watch.
Hey, Devon.
Not bad today, sis. Not bad at all.
You did that on purpose.
Did what on purpose?
Oh, come on, Dev. Cruise it in.
I don't know what you're talking about, mate. You went against the team order. It's poor form, that.
I can't believe I missed it at the time. It seems so obvious now.
Listen, you want to lay off the sauce, Cal. Seriously, it's a bit embarrassing.
I'm surprised Casper let you, to be honest. Really surprised.
Okay, I'm going now, because you're not making any sense. Okay? Ciao!
Yep. Ciao. Dad.
California.
That good enough for you?
Look, I thought we maybe could grab a coffee tomorrow before we head off. My flight's not till 3.
Yeah,
have a chat about next season. It'd be good for us. We'll think about it anyway. The offer stands.
You make it sound like a negotiation.
It always is with us, Callie. You let me know.
It was amazing. I'm not sure I've ever seen a race like that. I was wrong about Callie.
And how did you feel about the engine failure?
There's no such thing as the perfect car. The one that failed us was the same one that got us here in the first place. So, you've just got to drive the car you're in.
Everyone's an individual. Which means that everyone is, motivated a little differently. Take Devon as an example. He always responds well to having his ego brushed, to being told that he's the best. His greatest fear is failure, so it gives him further to fall, keeps him hungry. Callie, on the other hand, has an innate drive to prove people wrong. If someone tells her something's not possible, she'll do everything in her power to achieve it. A sort of stubborn determination that can be harnessed. And then there's Aiden. I mean, when he started in F1, people thought he was a nice guy, but he was incredibly ambitious. It's just what makes Aiden tick. Which is why I may have started a rumor or two about interest from other teams during his time at Konnersport to stoke that ambition. Keep his eyes on the horizon.
A lot of people might see that as manipulative, wouldn't you agree?
Well, of course. Motivation is manipulation. It's the same thing.
Is it?
Look, the end justifies the means. After all, it's just business.
Looking forward to next season?
Just let me at it.
Will you stay next season?
I've told Casper I'll stay if he does.
Do you still have a job after your run-in with Davidoff?
Well, we'll see.
We did it! We secured the funding! What a team!
And that's all that matters.
Right now, yes, that's all that matters.
Okay, so we're done? Yeah? Cool.